We all have our grievances with YouTube, and one of the things they're criticised most on is communication. It's just so hard to actually speak to anyone there. So the burning question is, can you directly speak to somebody on the YouTube creator support team? You can, but you're not going to like the answer.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.com.
Top tip, Rob, always remember to turn on your Tetris lights. Okay, here we go. When was the last time you needed to contact YouTube about a problem? What was it? How far did you get? Let us know in the comments below. Just be aware, we probably can't help you directly on that one. Hello folks, welcome to vidIQ. My name is Rob. If this is your first time here, we are the YouTube tool and channel aims to help you get more views and save time in the process. Now, I don't often blow our own trumpet, but we here at vidIQ take communication very seriously. That's why we've got a dedicated support team answering your questions 24/7 and yours truly, reading every single comment that's posted here on our YouTube videos and trying my best to answer all of them that don't contain the words like, subscribe, comment, I'll do the same. The problem comes with scale, and that's where YouTube are right now, with nearly 2 billion users and hundreds of thousands of video creators all wanting their questions answered. Now, I think people are generally tolerant of the occasional bug or maybe a layout change which causes some consternation, but when it comes down to money, people want questions answered immediately. So with Adpocalypse or the YouTube Partner Program, if you're wondering what's going on, you don't want to wait for an update from a YouTube channel or a letter posted on a blog. You want to speak to somebody directly. Can you do that? The answer's yes, but let's take a look. Ironically enough, my mini story starts with me complaining to YouTube on Twitter about a layout change. To be fair to YouTube, their communication on Twitter has improved tremendously over the last 6 months, so if there is no other way for you to contact YouTube, try them at Team YouTube on Twitter. Within a couple of hours, we were chatting to Team YouTube, and they suggested giving feedback through the link on screen now. I'll leave a direct link in the video description. The link takes you to the Contact YouTube Creator Support Team, and this is where things get really interesting because this layout is customized depending on your account. If you meet the requirements, you will have live chat. This looks awesome, right? Well, get ready for the bombshell. In order to access live chat, you will need 25,000 subscribers and over 100,000 watch time hours in the last 12 months. Hold on. 1, 2, 3. That's 6 million minutes of watch time, or to put it another way, 11.4 years of watch time on your channel over a 12-month period. Who's done that? I mean, the only reason we can see it is because we've got special access to a hidden YouTube channel. Actually, that's not true. That's my old channel called the Video Gadgets Journal, where instead of saying enjoy your video making day, I used to say enjoy your tech day. And I've got the play button here to prove that. And that came before vidIQ, where I also got 100,000 subscribers. But the problem is I actually damaged this play button here, so I had to buy another one from YouTube, which meant I now have three play buttons. Sorry, have I gone off topic here? If you don't have 25,000 subscribers and over 100,000 hours of watch time, this is the screen that's going to greet you, minus the chat option. In the top right-hand corner, there is a Get Support button. If you click it and go through the various options, you're going to end up with the recommendation to send an email to YouTube Support, and then you're in the same boat as everybody else. Now, if you are one of the lucky few to have the chat option, when you go to the Get Support button, go through the options, you can request a direct chat. And when I tested this, I was literally talking to a YouTube support person within about 30 seconds after completing this form. Just like this. Now, I bet you at around about the 240 mark on this video, audience retention dropped off a cliff. No doubt in the comments we've got accusations of clickbait and more dislikes than usual on this video, but hey, this is YouTube, that's the nature of the business. For those of you in the vidIQ community who are loyal enough to be still watching right now, first of all, thumbs up, and just post in the comments hashtag I'm still watching. That'll really confuse everybody else. And secondly, what do you think of YouTube's requirements here for direct online communication? It's probably somewhere in the top 5 or 3% of YouTubers who actually have access to this. Obviously, YouTube can't talk to everybody who creates videos. There's just far too much communication going on. Do you think it's fair what YouTube do right now? I'd love to hear your thoughts, of course, in the comments below. Now, if you are interested in memeing vidIQ, this is the perfect opportunity. Otherwise, if you want to know more about the situation of YouTube monetization in 2018, we've got a wonderful playlist right here. And if you're working towards monetization, 4,000 hours of watch time, 1,000 subscribers, we've got another wonderful video in the bottom right-hand corner right now. These are very heavy, so I'll see you on those videos right now. Enjoy the rest of your video-making day. Whew!